What are you doing in there? Let's go eat.
All right, today I'm gonna show you three places you should eat while in Dalat. I'm not gonna say must. I never wanna tell you what to do in life. We're actually one of my favorite breakfasts here in Dalat, Banh Can. Now, I've been here about a week and a half and I've tried all the famous ones you must go, but I accidentally stumbled upon this lady right here, super local, cooking up some delicious, wow, you can't see that because the sun's so bright. Anyways, her Banh Can are delicious. We're gonna get in here. I'm gonna show you making them and we'll show you how to eat this delicious breakfast in Dalat.
That was
Now, essentially what this dish is this beautiful stovetop? What would you call this? I don't know, it almost looks like a nice clay pot, hot oven stovetop. But you see what she does? She'll pour in that rice batter, and then there's two ways which she can make it. She'll kind of scramble up her little quail eggs and put it on top, or she'll just crack one directly on top of that rice flour mixture. It has one of the best sounds in the world. When she scrapes that, gets that nice little charred bottom, and then she'll sandwich them together, put them on a plate, and send them your way. I love the process of watching her cook this. As you see, she's nothing like a humongous stall like the really famous ones here, but I found hers just to be equally, if not more delicious than all the places everybody tells you to go in the city center. I'm so happy I stumbled across her and we got here on a good day. She actually has her shumai and she has the swai, which is gonna be the mango. Gotta have the mango in the dipping sauce here to have it at its maximum deliciousness. Now, this meal is absolutely the definition of what's bothering me. Sauce makes the meal, the definition of it. The sauce is what makes this meal so delicious. And now, in reality, there may be two sauces which you can order here. You can get the Nuk Mom or you can get the Mom Nim. But in honesty, there's really only one decision you can make. You have to get the Mom Nim. If you don't order Mom Nim, we probably shouldn't be friends. Ah, that legendary sauce is here. While we're waiting on the actual Banh Can to get here, we're gonna go ahead and doctor it up. Now, let me tell you something. If your Banh Can place is not doing it with the swai, with the mango, leave. Get out of there. You need that in that sauce. For me, it's a lot of mango, just a touch of chili, and a dusting of the crushed up peanut. Sorry, I'm trying to do this left-handed. That final step, you gotta add in that chai kay. The suu dal nan, being the actual soybean milk. Reconnecting with this in the mornings has brought me so much happiness here in Dalat. That is fresh off that hot stove. That is steaming hot. Fog up the camera, steaming hot. Now, one of the reasons I love eating here so much is because of her sauce. I told you this is a sauce up meal, so this plays a big factor in it. Anybody can really cook these up perfectly, so it's really all about how the sauce is done right. The reason hers hits home for me is because when you make the Mom Nim mixture, they usually add sugar, they probably dilute it a little bit, but she's really keeping a very strong, funky Mom Nim flavor, not adding a lot of sugar, so you really get that pungent, funky taste early in the morning, which is what I'm wanting when you dip these in here. And look what's all going in that sauce. She put the shumai in there. She got the mahan, which is actually the fried scallions and oil. And that Mom Nim mixture. Of course, we added the mango, some chilies, and the dusting of the peanut. Truly deserves the saying, gong kwa. Absolutely delicious. Her actual rice batter mixture is done, so it's just a slight touch ooey and gooey. It's soft. You get that nice little charred bit on the outside. The egg is cooked all the way through. I wish it did have just a little bit of just softness to it, but you know, that would be me really, really nitpicking. Look at that. When that mango just gets soaked in that sauce. just hits it point on for me. Less sugar, more of the funk and piquant flavor from the mom. Them, because me, I want my sweetness to be coming from that mango. I want to add a lot of that mango in there. It gives you that texture, gives you that sweetness, that fruitiness, that tartness. And then you get it with the chili, then you get it with the savory, ooey, gooey Banh Can. I don't know who came up with this, but I love them and you're an absolute genius. Little jacquet action, now it's soaked. A little hard, a little dense for me. I've had softer, I've had better. Not bad. I do know sauce can cover a thousand sins, so, you know, you put it in the sauce though and everything is A-okay. I tell you what, that shumai is cut like butter. Let's see if we can go lefty. The best part is when you get to the bottom, you're able to scoop up more of the fried scallions. You're able to get more of the chilies. It actually just gets better and better as you eat it. The only problem is when you drown each bite, you gotta go back and get more sauce. Now we can continue our scheduled programming. I tell you what, if I did not have more to film today, I would sit there and eat 3 or 4 plates of that. You can get it where she does a soft boiled egg on top. I don't know how to ask for it, so that's how I really, really want it, where she just cracks the egg on top and it's still a little bit soft and it'd be absolutely perfect. I need to work on my Vietnamese then. More motivation to work on Vietnamese. Welcome to Chợ Đà Lạt, or Market Đà Lạt. And we are here for one reason and one reason only. Well, two, I want to show you the market, and B, I need some nuts. So I eat like the best peanuts ever, but I'm out and I bought them in Saigon, so I'm here at the market. I'm gonna dive deep into it and hope I can find some nuts. Let's get it. Now, I don't know where these would be, but if I was some delicious nuts, I feel like it would be this area with the dried fruit in the nuts. So I think we're close. I'm gonna be really sad if I can't find them, because in this market you got every type of dried fruit that Mother Nature has produced. So let's see if their nut game is equivalent to their dried fruit game. No, that's not bad. See, and that's where samples work. Still don't have my peanuts, but I'm getting some of that baparang, which is kind of like a, I guess it just means fried corn. Over 50 years old, the hot spot to come to get stuff. But in case you're wondering, they ain't got no salty nuts. Well, at least the type that I wanted. Okay, next thing we're going for is Banh Uot Long Ga. Pretty much you come to the lat, you've got to eat the chicken. So this is a chicken dish, which you've got to try. And I have a confession. This is my first time eating it too. I don't know how I've not eaten it. I've been too busy eating all the lao and the all the other delicious things. So it's gonna be a first for both of us. I'm gonna kind of get there, look at it, get up closer to it, and learn more about it. So let's go. So I'm actually walking up on the most famous one in Dalat, or at least by rating wise. I don't know if it's the most delicious or not. And you'll see, I'm down an alley of an alley. So hard to find. And on the way here, you'll pass 30 of these. So make sure to keep trekking and find the correct one. So pretty much this place is open all day. So you gotta take advantage of coming through weird hours. So you can have the place to yourself. Some of my favorite. I hate being in the way. Oh, I hate feeling like I'm just taking up somebody's space, especially when they're hungry. Because I get hangry. So now other people do too. I gotta say, I love this place. It's like walking in somebody's home. You see the kitchen, you got that big fridge. Balling with that chandelier though. Super relaxed, mid-afternoon vibes. I think everybody's kind of taking their little siesta right now. Look at this, prepping the chicken ready to go and go and go. She's gonna grab a big old bowl. She's gonna throw in the sauce, the herbs, all those other spices and mix it up and get ready to keep cranking out bowl after bowl after bowl. Oh shoot, I blinked and it's here. She cranked out a few of these. I mean, she just whipped it up like that. Here's how we're doing it right here. You get that one bowl that's got those flat rice noodles, and then she took that chicken mixture, puts it on top, hits it with some fried shallots. Or if she got a little other going in there, if it's just that simple sauce, chicken and rice noodle, I'm not sure. We're gonna have to dig in a little deeper and find out. And then of course you gotta get the extra plate of the chicken, because that's what they're famous for. Can't come and just get a little bit. Okay, so we actually just got the chicken because they're out of the long ga already, which is kind of surprising because they're open till 7 p.m. So I guess if you want that, you got to come early in the morning. But look at this. Look at these rice noodles. I tell you what, I could use these on a cold night here in Dalat. They are just thick and look like they could keep you nice and warm at night. Let's get a little bit of everything. Let's go that money bite. First bite, money bite, starting off strong. Just Nook Mom sugar, a little bit of oil, some crushed black pepper, and MSG. Very simple, letting the chicken be the star of the show, because it needs to be. Really reminds me a lot of like a Hainanese chicken, the way it's so soft. Got that gelatinous part with the skin. It's just tender, saturated with the juices. The mouthfeel on this is absolutely addicting with the noodles, with the soft tender chicken. It's also silky, so smooth, so subtle. It's just something you could eat every single day. So these noodles are almost more like a Banh Can noodle, but they just haven't rolled. They've just done the steaming process and then kind of cut them up into these bed sheet forms. And again, maybe I took a gamble today getting the last jjajangmyeon on my table. Oh, this one looks so much better than the one from this morning. Look at this. Look how soft that is. Look at this. Gonna have the initial snap. Ooh. And then the inside just looks so soft. Try to get some of that sauce with the jjajangmyeon. Now that's what jjajangmyeon should be. That is just ultra soft, intense pork flavor, a little bit of sweetness, a little bit of fish sauce. And I told you I come at weird times. Sometimes I feel bad for the times I come at because they expect nobody. See, they're having actually a family meal right now. Kind of feel like a jerk. But I also don't want to be here when they're ultra busy too, so. I don't know, what is the right thing to do? Come here, that's the right thing to do. Here's siesta time. Can you see him? He's hot, spread back, ready to enjoy his afternoon. Oh, and just the time I ate, it got busy in there. You want to do yourself a favor, get there early in the day, get the extra chicken, get everything they have. Delicious. I think everything they're doing is phenomenal. Cool atmosphere, like you're in somebody's house. But after all that spice, kind of feeling something, kind of want to cool down, and there's actually something in Dalat that's very famous for to help cool you down, and that is the kimba. I got a place, well, another one that's supposedly supposed to be the best kimba here in Dalat, so we're gonna head to it, try to cool off this mouth a little bit. Yeah, let me tell you something. So this spot just opened up back yesterday, and if you try to come here at night, you better be very patient because you're gonna have to wait. So it makes me think, the kimba here just has to be amazing. So I've come here at an odd hour, still full of motorbikes, but looks like I won't have to wait as long. I'm craving some kimba right now after all that spice too. So let's get in here, see if it's the best. Whoa. Sometimes I'm not made for the size of these chairs and tables. Wow, maybe because it's Sunday or they just reopened, but I want to get the chè here too, the chè tap kem, but they were sold out. So I settled for the chè tai, and then of course their famous kimba. So chè tai, iconic things. You can see you got your jellies, you got your jackfruit, and you got their salad ring or your durian on top. Mix it all in here. I'm not big on jellies and stuff, but again, when you cover it all in, that thick, rich coconut milk. But let's not hold off the main star of the show. The reason you come here, the thing you see at everybody's single table, which is the kimba. You see, ba is actually the avocado. So you almost got like an avocado smoothie here. They're gonna give you a dollop of the kim, which is gonna be the ice cream. I'm just guessing. It's a coconut ice cream too. Now I'm kind of curious, because this place has been closed, I've been eating kimba all over Dalat. So I'm curious if this stacks up. It truly is the best. Let's quit anticipating, let's check it out. What I like to do, get some of that ice cream, looks nice and icy, and then lots of the actual avocado. You know, I've had better. It's just missing something. The avocado to me just doesn't taste as actually rich, as savory, as creamy, as silky, smooth. And it's actually hidden a lot with a lot of sweetness. I like a little bit less sweet, a little more creamy, silky, smooth. So for me, I actually have others I prefer, so that means I gotta go make a video about them. You know, I'm not saying it's not delicious, it's definitely hitting the spot right now after all those chilies. I would eat this many, many times. It's just not my outright favorite, and it's just gonna come down to preference. A fun dessert that'll make a kid out of anybody. And clearly loved by many, many, many people. Not sure if tourists or locals or a combination of both. For me though, I am a one and done guy. I'm just not big into fighting in crowds anyways. So that's gonna wrap it up. I hope y'all enjoyed today. A fun, beautiful Sunday here in Dalat. Still got so much more to come. Y'all know, it's been Max. Peace.